Hi everyone, the weather is changing, so I thought it would be great to make a vegetable soup. I've still got vegetables and herbs growing in my garden, so I thought I would throw those in. So this thing is chock full of, you know, good stuff. I've got greens going into this. We've got some beans, I've got garlic, onions, carrots. I mean, just a whole boatload of nutrition going into this. Now, how do we make this taste amazing? Well, I'm gonna show you two things that you really must do in order to bring out the best flavor, and you're gonna love this soup. I'm Rockin' Robin, and I'm gonna show you how to make it right after this. Time for a chef joke. All right, so what did the yam say to the pumpkin? I am what I am. If you like my chef jokes, hang around because I got one more for you a little bit later. Did I mention how simple and easy this recipe is? You're gonna love it. There is a lot of chopping involved, but it is so easy to do. Now we're gonna start with tip number one, all right? And we're gonna take some yellow onion and we're gonna dice it up. I'm gonna use the super fine dice just because I like small pieces of onion. We're gonna also add some sliced celery and carrot. And we're gonna chop all these things up. And then I'm gonna use some bell pepper as well. I have one bell pepper out of my garden. I wanna use it up, it's nice and fresh. And we're gonna saute this in some olive oil for about 5 to maybe even up to 10 minutes. And I'm gonna add a little garlic towards the end. And this is going to add the most flavor into your soup and you're gonna love it. Now here's our mirepoix after almost 10 minutes. It's about 9 minutes right now. And you can see that the onions have definitely softened up and a little bit on the celery. Carrots are still a little crisp yet, but that's okay. Now it's time to add our garlic. So I'm gonna add some fresh garlic to this. Put it in my press here and just squeeze it out and slice it in. Then we want to stir this in and just saute for 1 minute more. And that's going to just, you can start to smell that garlic. It gets very aromatic. It smells wonderful. We want that to just mellow out. And then I'm going to pour this into my stock pot. So we're gonna be adding some fresh organic chard to this recipe. This one here I've had in the fridge for several days. It's getting a little wilty, but that's okay. This is perfect for this application. I'm just gonna trim it up. And I like to take some of the big stems out, so that's what I'm gonna do. I just don't care for it personally. You can leave it in if you like. I just want the leaves. So I'm just kinda cut the stem out of it. You can save the stems and put them in your smoothie or anything else you want to, you know, maybe you're doing a stir fry and you want to throw that in. That's a great thing to do with it. So basically I just take it all and I just scrunch it all up and chop it up. You don't want the pieces to be too big. You want to be able to fit it on your spoon when you're eating it. Looks pretty good. Now for tip number two. All right, we're gonna be using some fresh herbs in this, and you want to use fresh as opposed to dried, right? The flavor is just different, and it's so much fresher, and it just tastes so much better that the flavors are almost a little more subtle, so that's why I like it. Use fresh herbs, and organic if you can get it. So what we have here is some fresh Italian flat-leaf parsley. I've got some fresh basil out of my garden, and I've got some fresh thyme and sage out of my garden as well. So we're gonna chop all that up and then place it into our stock pot. So stack your basil leaves and then give them a nice roll and then we'll chop them up. Now for the thyme, peel off the little leaves and then chop those up. Now Now we'll treat the sage the same way as we did the basil. Stack the leaves, roll them, and then slice them and chop them. Now that we have all of our herbs in the pot, I just wanted to mention one little tip for you. This is a bonus tip. To keep your parsley and, say, cilantro fresh, I like to take a mason jar, put a few ounces of water in there, cut off the end of the stem there, put it in, cover it with a little plastic bag, put it in the fridge, and it'll keep like 2 weeks. So, next thing that goes in the pot, we're gonna add some pesto. This is store-bought pesto sauce that you can buy. Pick out your favorite. Ours is Armanino, so I'm just gonna add a little bit of that to our soup. And I'm also gonna add some Great Northern beans that are gonna be rinsed and drained. And I'm just gonna add it right in for a little bit of protein. All right, so now we're gonna add our chicken broth, and we're gonna add as much as we wanna make it thin, okay? So it's gonna be at least 4 cups. Now give that a stir. We're not gonna add any salt just yet because the pesto sauce, mine in particular, has a fair amount of salt in it. And so I wanna just see how it tastes, you know, with all the ingredients in there before I start adding salt. All right, I'm gonna add a little more chicken broth because I still have to add the chard to this, and it's gonna, you know, take up a little bit of that liquid. So I'm gonna add a little bit more, probably another cup. We're gonna put this on the stove, and I'm gonna bring it to a boil, and then I'm gonna lower it and simmer it for about 10 minutes, and then we'll add the chard. I'm gonna cover this because I don't want, as it's simmering, to lose too much of the liquid. All right, chef joke time. Why did the tomato get embarrassed? Because it saw a chickpea. All right, so here's our soup. It's been simmering now for 10 minutes. You can see we got a nice soft boil. Keep the lid on, keep the moisture in so it doesn't evaporate. Okay, so we're ready now to place the chard in there. You put in as much as you want, obviously. Give it a stir, and we'll let this go another, you know, 3 or 4, just a couple minutes. We'll just do a couple minutes, then I'm gonna taste it for salt. But this soup is so wonderful in terms of flavor and nutrition, and feel free to add any other vegetables. Asparagus would be great, chopped up, some zucchini, you know, anything you like, or just pick your favorites. Here's our beautiful soup. Ooh, it's hot, let me tell you, and it looks amazing. Vibrant colors. All right, so let's see if we can serve this up without dripping too much. Look at that, beautiful colors. You've got the yellow from the bell pepper, and the carrots are orange and bright. And of course, a lot of greenery going on in there. All right, that should be good. We got our beans, and like I said, so customizable. All right, let's get some of this and see how we like it. You know, this soup would actually be, in my opinion, would be great at Thanksgiving to serve. The colors are definitely fall colors, and the nutrition is there, and the flavor. Well, let's see. That is so fresh and vibrant. The flavors are excellent. Definitely take my tips and use them. You will love this soup if you do, I promise. If you'd like to try another fall recipe, go ahead and check out my pumpkin French toast. It's really delicious. I'm gonna leave a link for you right over there. Go ahead and click that right away and check it out. You're gonna love it. It's just perfect for fall. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, hit that like button, and leave me a comment. We'll see you next time.